Hey, what's going on? It's Society 282. So I like to get to work a little early so I can go ahead and knock out this video and then be able to post it later on in the day. Sometimes the bad thing is, as you can see, the sun is cracking here right now. It's coming over the ridge and it's blinding me. But I will not allow that to stop me from doing this. But what I want to talk about this morning is ensuring that people aren't discouraging you, all right, and you're not allowing individuals to discourage you from doing the things that you want to do. And even if they're trying to, use that as your own encouragement, right? You know, there's going to be so many things that you try to do in life that some people are just not going to, you know, say, hey, good job, or say, you know, that's good for you to do, or they're not going to get behind you, they're not going to support you. And that's fine, because at the end of the day, you don't need everyone else's support. You don't need everyone else's encouragement. You don't need anybody at all. You only need to know that you're worth what it is that you're trying to accomplish. You know that you are the most important individual within the room, right? You're the most important individual when it comes to accomplishing your goals, and you're the one that's in charge of it. So when other people try to discourage you from doing things, and you know that it's the right thing to do, you know it's something that's going to help you and make you a better individual, a better person, a better father or husband or wife, whatever, use that discouragement and flip it as encouragement, because who cares what they think? You know, we've talked about it so many different times. There's going to be those that are out there that are hating, and just don't allow that to affect you. So recently I decided, like I said, you know, yesterday, I think, that I'm going to go back to school and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go after my master's degree. And the encouragement, and the support that I got was, overwhelming, and I appreciate that. But I look at it in this light, that even if I didn't get any encouragement, or even if I wouldn't have gotten any support, I had already made the decision, right? I had made the decision that this is what I was going to do, and I wasn't going to allow, you know, even individuals that come out of left field or right field and like naysayers, and I was not going to allow that to affect me, because I am the one that made the decision to do what it is that I'm going to do. And now it's my goal and, you know, and my journey to go ahead and accomplish that. And in a couple years, you know, look back on when I started this journey, and just like I've done previously, seeing the road that it took me to get there, seeing the accomplishments that I was able to, you know, slowly but surely, you know, gather, and use that as the momentum towards whatever's next. Because the only reason that I'm even going for my master's is because I was able to accomplish my bachelor's. And the only reason I was able to accomplish my bachelor's was because I was able to accomplish my associate's. And that all came from making a decision, right? Sticking with something, taking a couple of classes, seeing that they weren't as hard as I personally and professionally believed they were, and then continued on and saw the progress that I was able to maintain, and saw that, you know what, it's not as bad as some people say. It's not as hard as some people say. Yes, there is work, right? There was work, and there was long hours, and there was headaches, and there was frustrations that went into, you know, this 5-year process of me completing my associate's and my bachelor's. But now I look at it, well, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put a couple more years into school in regards towards my master's, and there's going to be headaches, and there's going to be heartaches, and there's going to be, you know, frustrations that I have throughout, but that's not going to stop me from doing what it is that I want to do, because I've decided on it. So at the end of the day, no matter what, however it played out, when I said what I was going to do, I was not going to change. I was not going to allow that to alter anything that I've already decided on doing. And that's what you need to look at. You need to look at what are the things that you're trying to do in life, and whether you get encouragement or you get individuals that are out there that discourage you from doing the things that you do, don't allow that to affect you. You've decided on it, now do it. It's simple. I know it's one of those things that, well, it's probably harder than you say it is, but it's really not, because mentally, all right, once you've made that change, once you've made that adjustment, your mindset takes over. It is truly as easy as deciding and doing on whatever it is that you want to do. So until my next video, I appreciate you watching, Decide and Do.